And Allah says in Surah Buruj, chapter number 85, verse number 16, that Allah is the doer of all He intends. Whatever He intends, He can do. But He does not intend doing ungodly things like telling a lie, like making a mistake, like forgetting, like doing injustice, like becoming a human being. But the Quran says, Inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. For verily, Allah has power over all things. Allah can do whatever He intends, but He does not intend doing ungodly things like making a mistake, like forgetting, like doing injustice, like becoming a human being. That's the reason Almighty God will not become a human being. And the Quran clearly mentions in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 18, Summum, Bukmun, Umyun, Fahum, La Yarjiun, the deaf, the dumb, the blind, they will not return to the true path. A similar message is repeated in the Bible, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 13, verse number 13. They see, yet they see not. Hearing, they hear not. Neither do they understand. The same message repeated in Rig Veda, book number 10, hymn number 71, mantra number 4. They see the word, yet they see not. Some people hear the word, yet they hear not. All these scriptures, the Quran, the Bible, the Veda, they are saying, seeing they see not, hearing they hear not, neither do they understand. They are telling clearly that the scriptures are explicitly, in clear terms, mentioning that Almighty God is one. He has got no images. Worship Him alone. Yet, there are people, summum, bukmun, umyun fahum la yarjiun, the deaf, the dumb, the blind, they will not come to the true path. Hearing they hear not, neither do they understand. Rig Veda, book number 10, hymn number 71, verse number 4, that some see the word, yet they see not. Others hear the word, yet they hear not. All these scriptures are saying that the definition of Almighty God is given so explicitly in the major world religions, yet people behave like blind people, like deaf people, and do not follow the scriptures. And most of the major religions except Islam, they have a philosophy known as anthropomorphism, that Almighty God, He takes the form of a human being, He becomes a human being. It is known as anthropomorphism, except Islam. Most of the major religions believe that Almighty God became a human being once. Some believe He became a human being many times. And when you ask these people, they have a very good logic. That Almighty God, He's so pure, He's so holy, He does not know the shortcomings of the human beings. He does not know the difficulties of the human being. He's so pure, He does not know the feelings of the human beings. So Almighty God, so pure, so pious, so holy, He became a human being and He came in this world to know what is good or what is bad for the human being, so that He could set the rules for the human being. You know, Almighty God, so pure, so holy, so pious, He does not know the difficulties of human beings, the shortcomings of the human beings, the feelings of the human beings. So He became a human being to set the rules for the human being, the do's and don'ts. On the face of it, it sounds like a very good logic. But I tell these people that suppose I manufacture a tape recorder. I create a tape recorder. Do I have to become a tape recorder to know what is good or what is bad for the tape recorder? I write an instruction manual that if you want to play the audio cassette, insert the audio cassette and press the play button. If you want to fast forward, press the FF button. If you want to stop, press the stop button. Don't drop it from height, it will get damaged. Don't immerse it in water, it will get spoiled. I write an instruction manual. I don't have to become a tape recorder to know what is good or what is bad for the tape recorder, because I am the creator of the tape recorder. Similarly, when Almighty God, He is the creator of the human beings, He does not have to become a human being to know what is good or what is bad for the human being. What does He do? He reveals the instruction manual. And the last and final instruction manual for the human beings, it is the Quran. The glorious Quran is the last and final instruction manual revealed by Almighty God to the human beings. The do's and don'ts of the human being is mentioned in the Quran. Almighty God does not have to become a human being. What does He do? He reveals the instruction manual. And He chooses a man amongst men, and He communicates with them on a higher level, who we call as messengers or prophets of God. He does not have to come down on this earth and become a human being to know what is good or what is bad for the human being. He is the creator. He reviews the instruction manual. And the last and final instruction manual is the glorious Quran. The Quran says in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 110, Qulidullah Abidur Rahman, Ayamatadu, Falal Asmal Husna. Say call upon him by Allah or by Rahman. By whichever name you call upon him, to him belongs the most beautiful name. You can call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by any name, but it should be a beautiful name. It should be a name given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It should not conjure up a mental picture. And there are no less than 99 different attributes given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Hakim, most merciful, most benevolent, most wise. No less than 99. And the crowning one is Allah. And this verse, to Allah belongs the most beautiful name. Besides Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 110, is also mentioned in Surah Araf, chapter number 7, verse number 180, and Surah Taha, chapter number 20, verse number 8, as well as Surah Al-Hashr, chapter 59, verse number 24, to Allah belong the most beautiful names. There are certain criteria as far as the name and attributes of Allah are concerned. It should be a name given by himself. And besides that, it should be a unique name. For example, most of us know that the first man who set foot on the moon, he was Neil Armstrong. Now, if I have to give an attribute to Neil Armstrong, and if I say that Neil Armstrong is an astronaut, yes, Neil Armstrong is an astronaut, but it's not unique. There are thousands of astronauts. If you reverse it, who's an astronaut? The answer will not be Neil Armstrong. It can be a thousand people. If I say Neil Armstrong is an American, there are millions of people who are American. Who's an American? You can give a million names. It's not unique belonging to Neil Armstrong alone. So if I have to give a unique attribute to Neil Armstrong, I have to say, Neil Armstrong is the first man who set foot on the moon. If you reverse it, who's the first man who set foot on the moon? The reply is Neil Armstrong. So similarly, when you give an attribute to Almighty God, it should be unique. If you say Almighty God created a building, who can create a building? There can be a thousand people who can create a building. But if you say He is the creator or the creator of the universe, who is the creator of the universe? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahim, most merciful. Who is the most merciful? Answers only one, Allah. So the attribute you give and the name you give should be unique and belong only to Allah and no one else. Some people may say that why there should be only one God? Why can't there be many gods? If there would have been many gods, surely these gods would have fought among themselves. And we find this in the mythology of some of the religions. One God fighting with the other God. One God helping the other God to fight the third God. Can you believe in such a God who can be defeated, who can be killed? And some people say that why can't there be different God? One God for sun, one God for cloud, one God for wind. Now imagine if there was one God for each one having power over his own little thing. It's logical to have one God who has power over all things rather than each different God fighting among themselves. It's illogical. That's the reason the Quran says in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 22, that if there would have been gods besides Allah, surely there would have been confusion in the universe. It's mentioned in Surah Mu'minun, chapter number 23, verse number 91, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not beget a son. If there were gods besides Allah, each god would have taken things would have created and hoarded on the other. Surely there would have been infighting amongst them. That's what we see in the mythology. The best and the most logical is only one God, one and only, all-powerful, having power over all things. That is the reason, if you read the scriptures of the major world religions, all the scriptures of the major world religions, they say that Almighty God is one. He has got no images. He is not begotten. He is one and only, absolute and eternal. There is nothing like Him. And by the passage of time, many of the scriptures, almost all besides the Quran, these scriptures have changed.